I continue to look into different ways of making a character walk in a game made with a RenPy engine, walking under the control of the player. I am now going back to the method in my first video. There's a link in the description below, and I will expand on that idea. In the first video, we had a side view, and the player walked left or right to a point indicated with a mouse pointer and a mouse button click. It was strictly a movement in the X direction. We will now still use the mouse pointer and the mouse button click to decide to which point the player character will walk. This time, however, the player character will be able to walk in all directions, X direction, in Y direction, and any combination thereof. For this, we need a different kind of background. I am planning to use this technique in the game I am working on right now. This is the background I intend to use for a scene for this kind of walking. For this video, I will, however, use a slightly different version of this background. This is because there are a couple of different things I need to do to get the final effect, and I will not touch on all of them in this video. One thing I will not do is changing the scale of the player character as it goes farther away from the camera. With a background in a perspective mode, it will give the impression of the player character growing in size as it goes further away from the camera. With this simpler background, with an isometric look to it, that will not be that much of a problem. For the side view walk, we only needed a side view walk cycle with 6 images, one that could double as a standstill image. With a flip function, the same images can be used for walking either way. With a 360 degrees possibility of walking, we would at least want a walk towards the camera and walking away from the camera. In this video, I will, however, only use the same 6 images of a side view walk cycle. And you can indeed get away with this if you keep things simple. In the final version, I will have more sprites, but for now, we keep it pretty simple. The code we will be using in this video will be very similar to the code of the first video. I will not repeat everything from that video now. If you find it difficult to follow this video, you might want to see the earlier video first. We will have the same labels: stand right, stand left, walk right, walk left, and check fist. We have a screen for the only purpose of catching clicks of the left mouse button. At a mouse button click, when the character stands still, the game will jump to the label check this. The main job of the code under this label is to calculate the distance between the character's present position and the position that the character is to walk to. Then send the program to label walk right or walk left. This is basically the same thing that the original version of the game did. In the earlier version, we only had to calculate the distance in the X direction. Now we might have to calculate the distance between two points with different X and Y values. So we will need a bit of math here, and we will use Pythagoras' equation. Zeta equals the square root of the square of X plus the square of Y. To do this, we need to import the math library. Before going into the math, a few words on the coordinate system of the screen and the placement of an image on the screen using the positions XPOS and YPOS. The screen's origo is at the top left corner. The further right you go, the higher X point value, and the further down, the higher Y value. When you position an image on the screen using X-Pos and Y-Pos, it is the top left corner of the image that is the point that will decide where the image is placed. In this kind of walking, the point that is more interesting is the point at the feet of the character. So in this case, our SX and SY values will be in the middle of the bottom of each image. My sprites are all 74 pixels wide and 150 pixels high. So the images will be drawn at SX minus 37 and SY minus 150. Having all sprites the same size helps a lot. So the distance will be calculated between SX SY point and the MX MY point of the mouse pointer at the time of the mouse point click. If the mouse X point is larger than the character's SX point, we jump to the walk right label. In walk right, we set the variables stand right to 1. Mouse clicks will now not be picked up by the screen while the character is walking. The animated image is shown at its X position and Y position. X zoom is used to flip the image the right way or the left way under the label walk left. We use a linear movement of the image to the mouse's X position and Y position as defined at the mouse button click. The time is set to distance divided by 100. This way the speed will be the same if it is a short or a long walk. We have a hard pause for the time the walk takes and then changes the character's X and Y values to those of the mouse. This is pretty much the same thing as we did in the first video. The only difference is that we now have two directions and a different position of the SX and the SY values. We then jump to the label stand right. The variable stand walk is now set to 0. That means that the screen now is listening for mouse clicks again. The stand image is shown and we get a hard pause. The game is now waiting for a new input. And so we can keep walking from point to point. One thing that we want to limit is how far the character can walk. It should not be able to go outside the floor of the room. We have code for this under the label check list before the code to decide the distance to walk. What the code does is to change the MX or Y value to a point inside the floor area. This will be the point that the character will walk to and that the distance is calculated to. So the character will not be able to walk to a point outside the floor. There you have it. With some small changes, we have adopted the earlier side view only walking script to a 360 degrees walking in 2D. There is a link to the complete script in the description below. There are a couple of more things that should be done, but I will have to wait for a different time. So, for now, bye!